That's why I love the Lord for using the church to send a bus out to pick up my brother and sister and I, when we were children, and take us to church and Sunday school where we can hear about the love of Jesus Christ. And at the age of 14, I understood my need for Christ as my Savior, and I asked Him to save my soul, and He completely changed my life. So I'm thankful for the church, the family of God in that regard. I'm thankful for Parkview Baptist Church because as a young married couple, my husband and I came here and the church welcomed us and took us under their wing and loved on us and helped us grow up in Christ. We never, ever dreamt that one day He would be the pastor here. And I'm thankful for Parkview Baptist Church. This song made me think of someone else who loved Parkview Baptist Church and was a man who used to ride his bike past Parkview. And he was a Vietnam vet, and he had had a very sad life. He had seen a lot of sad things. But as it happened, the Lord had put my son Joseph on his paper route. And Joseph would deliver papers there, and they would strike up conversations. And Joseph began to invite Ken, his daughter, to church. And one day, Joseph came home, and he said, "Mom, I told Ken if he would come to church, you'd make him a roast beef dinner." And so Ken came to church. And in time, a preacher was able to lead Ken to the Lord. Ken loved his church. But this song made me think of him. And so the Lord will get the glory from this. Amen. Thank you.
from Sunday school this morning to the young couples about, we've been looking at the church a couple of weeks. One of the things we were talking about in the church is, of course, a hospital for the spiritually sick. It's a haven for those that have hurt and been banged up, you know. And it's just a blessing that people can come into God's house and be accepted, be spoken to kindly. We have to understand something, too, that when people do walk through our church doors, we that are saved and born again, we need to be friendly and kind in receiving, because it makes a big difference whether they come back and hear the Word of God preached and taught and so forth. We have the Reformers Unanimous Addiction Program, and they're just all kinds of people have been helped and restored through that ministry. I was thinking about Tully. I was thinking of Donna. I was thinking of Dave Greenshields. He preached to the group on Friday night about 13 years ago. He came 14 years ago and just drunk, and Austin's family, just a mess, and got straightened out and let the Lord into his heart and life. And